and welcome to the party classroom. It's so nice that you're joining me today for an English lesson all about semicolons. Now, oh, the phone is ringing. Oh, I bet it's the old wise lady. Shall we answer it? Oh, how exciting. Are you ready? Hello, Miss Charlotte speaking. Oh, hello, old wise lady. I thought it was you. Oh, yes, I'm fine, thank you. I'm just teaching the children. Are you wondering? Oh, yes, he's here. Oh, just hang on one moment, please. Okay. She wants to talk to Captain Clumsy. I am sure they know each other. He has definitely had something to do with this phone turning up on my doorstep, don't you think? I wonder what they're talking about. Oh, yes, it's Miss Charlotte again. Oh, you have a riddle. Oh, yes, I'm sure the children would like to hear it. What is black and white and red all over? Oh, I don't know. Oh, yes, well, I'll ask them. Oh, you'll call back later? Oh, lovely. Okay, thank you. Talk to you later. Bye-bye. Oh, fantastic. She's got a riddle for us. What is black and white and red all over? Well, goodness me, I'm not quite sure. How can something be black and white, but then it's red all over? Oh, that's a strange riddle. Oh, that'll keep you thinking, won't it, children? So we can think about that throughout the lesson, and hopefully she'll call us by the end of the lesson to give us the answer. But what I was talking about before the old wise lady rang was about semicolons. Now, have you ever heard of semicolons before? They are a type of punctuation, and they are a little bit like a colon and a little bit like a comma. And they are really important when we are writing longer pieces of writing, and also when we're really hoping to impress our teacher or an examiner. Now, before I explain anything about the use of a semicolon and what it is for, it is important to make sure you know what they look like. Now, you will be able to see on the screen underneath me lots of examples of semicolons. I have deliberately put these examples here because they show you semicolons in different fonts. These have all been typed. So you will easily be able to recognise a semicolon in a piece of typed text. But what's really important is knowing how to write a semicolon neatly in your handwriting. And I'm going to show you some examples now. So I have got here just hello and goodbye, just words, doesn't mean anything necessarily to do with the semicolon. It was just to show you how to write a semicolon. Okay, so if I wanted to put a semicolon after the word hello, I would do it like this. Can you see that? I'll just zoom in a little bit. There you go. So we have got, it almost looks like a colon, but then I've made this bottom bit a comma. And what's important to take note of, children, is if you imagine the handwriting lines that you will have used when you were a lot younger, when you were learning your handwriting. Do you remember, you'd have a lot of dotted lines, wouldn't you? The semicolon does not go above the top of a smaller letter. These lowercase letters tell you how high to make your semicolon. If you made your semicolon this big and you did your comma down there, it would not be right. Yes, it is clear. We can obviously see it as a semicolon, but it has to be in lines. I'm going to rub it out. It has to be in line with the lowercase letters. Let's have a look at this one here. So I've just written the word goodbye, nothing to do whatsoever with a semicolon, but just to show you the best way to lay it out, I need to make sure the top of it, a little dot like a colon, it does not go above the lowercase letters. And then underneath, I do a comma. Okay, now I'm making a big deal about this because actually it is quite important. Years ago in the year 6 SATs, a child lost a mark in the English exam because they made their semicolon too big. They made their semicolon like this. They did not get the mark because the examiner said it looked like the letter J. And to be honest, I can kind of see that. I can see that. I think it's quite harsh, to be honest. I'd give the mark. But you can see it does look a little bit like the letter J. The semicolon has to be a bit smaller. So we just do a nice dot and then a comma underneath it. Do not make your comma huge because that looks like it could look like the loop on a J. So on this one, I've just written Mr. Cuddles, just as an example to show you. Okay, and you can see there, I've got a nice clear semicolon. And if I was doing this on my handwriting paper, you would be able to see on my little dotted lines, the top little dot does not go above the S. You want to make sure this dot isn't just a quick prick with your pencil or your pen, because you will hardly see it. Do make it nice and clear so it is possible to see that you are doing a semicolon, but do not make them ginormous. You will not impress your teacher or the examiner, okay? So just remember that when you're writing them. Before we carry on and I actually talk to you about what a semicolon is and when we would use them, I want you now with a piece of paper and a pen or a pencil to actually have a go at writing semicolons in a row. Remember to keep them nice and small, but keep them clear. I will see you in a moment. Okay, welcome back. How did you get on? Were your semicolons nice and neat and clear? We are now going to talk about when you would use a semicolon. To be honest, it's pretty simple. A semicolon sits between two independent clauses or simple sentences. You could join up your two simple sentences with a connective like and, but, so. Or you could use a semicolon. Let's do a few examples so I can show you what I mean. Let's think, for example, it is a sunny day. I need my sun cream. It is a sunny day is a simple sentence. I need my sun cream is a simple sentence. So I could have those as two separate sentences, or I could use a connective in between them. It is a sunny day, so I need my sun cream. However, you could take out the connective and replace it with a semicolon. Hey presto, you've done it. I told you it was easy, didn't I? Let's do another one. I am really hungry. Tea should be ready soon. I am really hungry is an independent clause. It's a simple sentence. Tea will be ready soon is also a simple sentence or an independent clause. I could put a connective in between them. I am really hungry, but tea will be ready soon. I could take the but, the connective, out of that and put in a semicolon instead. Hey presto, you've done it. Easy peasy. The rule you really need to remember with semicolons is that the two simple sentences need to have something to do with each other. It would not work if they are totally random and nothing to do with each other. For example, I love the colour pink. Mr. Cuddles is sleepy. Well, that wouldn't work, would it? Those two sentences have nothing whatsoever to do with each other. What about this one? I like to go dancing. I have some cheese in my fridge. Do they have anything to do with each other? No, they don't. So I could not put those together with a semicolon. They would have to stay as separate sentences. I am now going to put up on the screen sentences next to each other, and you need to decide if a semicolon can be used in between them. Remember, they absolutely have to have something to do with each other in order for them to be joined together. But before I just put that on the screen, I just want to tell you this. The letter after a semicolon does not need to be a capital. It would only be a capital if it was a proper noun. You need to remember that. We'll do a little bit more work on that when we come back after this little section. So have a look at the screen and I want you to decide if the two independent clauses could be joined together with a semicolon, or if they're two separate and they're nothing to do with each other and you would have to keep them separately. I'll see you in a moment. Right, how did you find that? Was it okay? Now, just before you did that little task, I just briefly mentioned to you about the letter that comes straight after a semicolon. It does not need to be a capital. The only instance in which it would be a capital letter is when it is a proper noun. So for example, if it said, I like my capital city. London is amazing. Because London is a proper noun, it starts with a capital L anyway, so it has to have a capital L still after the semicolon. Another example could be, I live on a very busy street. Oakbeck Avenue is full of people. Well, Oakbeck Avenue, that is a proper noun, isn't it? So it has to have a capital O. However, if I was going to write a sentence about, I need to go to the supermarket. There is no food in my house at the moment. The T for there, which comes straight after the semicolon, it does not need to be a capital letter because it's not a proper noun. So that's something just really important to remember, okay? Now, the next thing that we're going to look at is using semicolons, and you're going to have a little bit more of a go on your own. I'm going to put up on the screen some independent clauses, and you, with your pen and paper, need to write down either the independent clause that comes before the semicolon or the independent clause that comes after the semicolon. Basically, you need to fill in the gaps. I will see you in a moment. You are doing so well. Here is a big thumbs up from me. Excellent. This looks like I have a big thumb to be a big hitchhiker, doesn't it? But really, it's just a big thumbs up. I'm really pleased with you. Well done. Now, the exercise that you have just completed, to be honest, is fairly easy because all you had to do was fill in the blanks. What's really important is actually applying this new knowledge of semicolons into longer pieces of writing. Now, next to me is going to come up some text on the screen, and we're going to work out where the semicolon goes. Let's look at the first one. The creepy house stood proudly on top of the hill. It had old black gates. Opening them would lead you into the depths of hell. Okay, there's no semicolons in that. Do you think maybe we could add any in? Where do you think on this piece of text a semicolon could go? Let's have a good look, have a good think, read it again carefully to yourself. Where could a semicolon go? I'll give you a clue. It will replace a full stop that's already there. It could actually replace the full stop that in the sentences that talk about the gates. It had big black gates. Opening them would lead to the depths of hell. Maybe if we take out that full stop and replace it with a semicolon, that would work, wouldn't it, children? Because that is all about the gates. So there we have managed to do an example where we're actually applying this into a piece of text. Let's do another one. All right, let's do another one. Look at the text next to me. Although peering up at the smiling sun, Captain Clumsy had a sad heart. He was homesick. He just wanted to see his dear friend, Mr. Cuddles. Oh, poor Captain Clumsy. Well, they're reunited now, aren't they? Which is nice. So So let's think, where could a semicolon go in this short piece of text? Remember, a semicolon can replace either a connective or a full stop. Let's have a think, have a good look at that piece of text for a moment. Although peering up at the smiling sun, Captain Clumsy had a sad heart. He was homesick. He just wanted to see his dear friend, Mr. Cuddles. Well, I think the last two sentences could be joined together with a semicolon, don't you? So if we take away the full stop that's already there, and we need to then replace it with a semicolon, and that would work. The capital H on the second sentence then needs to turn into a lowercase h, because those are the rules when we use semicolons, aren't they? Do you understand? Well done. So we've used another piece of text there as an example to think when we would use a semicolon. So we've looked at replacing full stops with semicolons, but remember, we can also replace connectives as well, which is what we're going to do now. Have a look at the text next to me. The small boy ran through the supermarket looking for his mum, and he was relieved to finally find her. She grabbed him and shouted, "Don't run off again!" So, where could a semicolon go in this piece of text? Remember, we don't necessarily have to use a semicolon if we don't want to, but it shows a deeper level of understanding of the use of punctuation. So if you can use a semicolon and it makes sense to and it follows the rules, well, you may as well. So in this instance, in this piece of text, can you spot the connective? Have a good look in the first sentence. Can you see the connective? Have you found it? It's and. He was looking for his mum and he was relieved to finally find her. We could replace the connective with a semicolon. So take out the and replace it with a semicolon. But let's think why that works. Let's just recap those rules one last time. We have got two independent clauses now. The small boy ran through the supermarket looking for his mum. That is an independent clause. He was relieved to finally find her. That is another independent clause. They both have something to do with each other. So you can put them together with a semicolon instead of using the connective. You've done so well today. I'm very impressed with you for your good concentration. What I'd like you to do as your final task is... Oh, yes, the phone is ringing again. It's the answer time. Oh my goodness, did you manage to work the riddle out? Should we find out what the answer is? Hello, Miss Charlotte speaking. Hello, old wise lady. Yes, we were looking forward to hearing from you. Yes, you've got the answer. Oh, brilliant. What is it? What's black and white and red all over? Well, I couldn't think of it because I can't work out what is black and white, but then how can it be red all over? A newspaper. Ah, well, that makes sense because red is a homophone, isn't it? I was thinking as red as the colour, not red as in reading. Oh, very good. Yes. Oh, thank you, old wise lady. Yes, thank you. Oh, I look forward to hearing from you again. Bye for now. Who'd have thought? A newspaper. Did you get that, children? Black and white is the colour of a newspaper, but it's red all over because you sit and you read it. It wasn't talking about the colour red. Oh, fantastic. We'll have to see if she rings back another time. What was I saying before she called? Oh, that's right. I would like you, as your final task now, is to write your own pieces of text. Do not worry, you don't need to write loads and loads. It's just about giving you a go at using semicolons and applying it properly to your own piece of work. I'm going to put up a few pictures on the screen, and I would like you to use them as your inspiration to write something where you can incorporate semicolons into it. So you have been amazing today. I am so pleased with you. I can now start my party because you have worked so hard. I will see you next time. Bye for now from the party classroom.
Christchurch.